Sounds good. Hey, that's one of my victims. Hey, man, appreciate you watching the video, bro, for real. God bless you. All right, hey, this is your ticket. Sorry, we gotta go. But it's your ticket, man. Take care, all right? Bless you, brother. God bless you.
Tell him.
What?
Hey, you too. I'll be watching you as soon as I get home. Tell him to tell us this is not my people.
Okay. Sounds good, man. Hey, you heard him. Y'all better watch the videos, all right? Subscribe. If you're new to this channel, make sure y'all subscribe to this channel.
On June 25th, 2022, in Kendall, Wisconsin, an officer...
Welcome to Straight Talk with Daphne Finney. I am so excited to give you another exclusive one-on-one interview with the one and only...
At this very moment, your life is being guided and in.
There's a new way to save for retirement in today's workforce. Select the fund with the target date closest to the year you want to retire. And the fund will adjust from growth oriented to a more balanced portfolio as you near retirement, so you can save the date for your future.
Always in stat. You believe if it's well made, comfortable, it makes you feel good.
On June 25th, 2022, in Kendall, Wisconsin, an officer was dispatched to a residence due to reports of a highly intoxicated male driving a tractor. While en route, the officer was notified that the male was on probation with special conditions to not possess or consume alcohol.
Here I am, Deputy Kruger at the Sheriff's Office. Is everything okay? Okay. Well, it sounds like they're just concerned. Maybe you need an ambulance or something?
No, we're fine.
You're fine?
Yeah, we're fine.
Okay. So what's going on today? How'd you get here? Did you need help getting down?
No, we're fine.
So what do you guys are concerned with the truck?
No.
Okay.
Yeah.
How are you?
And his father.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right. Ryan, where are you coming from? How'd you get here?
Well,
sounds like he drove a tractor down C all the way.
I'm all the way from, well, yeah, P.
Tony P.
We're good. We're good.
I got you. Ryan, have you had anything to drink? No. I can smell the alcohol, and I just want to make sure you're okay.
I'm fine.
Okay.
If I can put this away, it's gonna be great.
Put what away?
My foot.
Okay.
Can you figure that out?
No. How to get
it out?
Okay.
That's all right. Just figure it out.
Are you sure? I don't want you to fall.
No.
He's coming off
your
flat on his face.
No, just go away. Goodbye. Good night.
All right, have you had anything to drink today?
Not enough.
Go away.
Okay.
Well, the reason I ask is because you also have, you know, conditions. You're not supposed to be drinking that.
Yeah, just leave me alone. Leave me alone.
Okay. Get down off of there.
Leave me alone.
Right, so you drove here from where? Okay, well, why is everyone telling you you drove here?
I didn't drive nowhere.
What time did you get here? So here's the deal, I mean, I don't want to have to call probation and parole.
That's just, you know something? Go away. Go away. Leave us alone.
Alright, can you get them off the tractor? Yeah. Safely?
Yeah, I can. Go away.
Yeah, well,
leave us alone.
I can't go away yet.
Yeah, you can.
31 to 30, what's your 20? Did you physically see him driving? No.
There's parked and shut off when I got here.
Okay. Amy, was it? So you said your sister or some other family had physically saw him driving?
My brother-in-law.
Brother
saw him.
I got you. What's his name?
Excuse me, bed up here.
And back to that video of an arrest uncovered for the first time following a month-long WBTV investigation. Take a look. The video shows what happened when officers with the Matthews Police Department arrested Aaron Butler for being drunk and disorderly in public. The arrest happened more than 3 years ago, but town leaders have kept the video secret, even spending tax dollars to pay a lawyer to go to court to try and keep this video from being released. WBTV's chief investigative reporter Nick Ochsner is digging deeper into the story, asking the Matthews town manager why she's spending your money to keep you from seeing the video.
So when you watched that video, what was your reaction?
The video that we watched, it clearly showed that there was a notable violation of our use of force policy.
Matthews town manager Becky Hawk answered my questions about this leaked video. Shows a Matthews police officer choking a man. His hands are cuffed behind his back. The town spent months fighting to keep it secret. The sergeant in that video is Joshua Burnett. He was ultimately fired for what you see. According to his termination letter, Burnett lied about what happened.
Michael, how does Next Door and Window make shopping for windows easier?
At Next, we don't have pushy salespeople.
Is a mixed one. Remember both as a football star and actor, as well as for being acquitted of killing his former wife and her friend in a murder trial that captivated the nation. Tia is in Studio 32 with a look back at his life and his legacy. Tia?
Well, Terrence and Sylvia, let's talk about it. His death was announced on X today, his family stating that he died in Las Vegas following a prostate cancer battle nicknamed the Juice. OJ first rose to fame.
star. In college, he led the nation in rushing twice and won the 1968 Heisman Trophy. He also went on to have a celebrated NFL career and was elected to the Pro Football Hall of Fame. Simpson also went on to have an acting career, remember, for roles that included the Naked Gun films. But perhaps what most still associate with his name is the trial against him for the 1994 killings of his ex-wife, Nicole Brown Simpson, and her friend, Ronald Goldman, in Los Angeles. He was arrested after this, the famous slow-speed chase, but ultimately, Simpson ended up being acquitted. Simpson was later found liable for the deaths in a separate civil case, then served 9 years in prison on unrelated charges. Among those, speaking out today, Captain Cato Kalin, who was a witness in the O.J. Simpson murder trial.
Foremost, I'd like to express my condolences to the children, to Sydney, to Justin, to Jason Marbell. They lost their father. That's never easy. I wish to express my loving compassion to the Goldmans, to Fred, to Kim. I hope you find closure. And finally, to the family of beautiful Nicole Brown Simpson, may we always cherish her memories.
Well, coming up at 4:15, we are talking to TMZ about Simpson's legacy and the reaction that is pouring in from around the world. And Fred Goldman, Long's dad, lives right here in the valley. Our very own Mark Curtis sat down for an exclusive interview with him in July 2017. Mark called Mr. Goldman again this morning to get his reaction.
Online crime is soaring, and things you do on the internet every day may put you at risk with Aura.
He and his wife, Kim, sent us this statement here. It reads in part, "The news of Ron's killer passing away is a mixed bag of complicated emotions. For 3 decades, we tirelessly pursued justice for Ron and Cole, and despite a civil judgment and his confession in If I Did It, the hope for true accountability has ended. We will continue to advocate for the rights of all victims and survivors, ensuring our voices are heard both within and beyond the courtroom." Let's take a look back now at what Mr. Goldman had to say nearly 7 years ago about his new normal after his death.
O.J. Simpson, there has been no formal police action, but the coroner's report is in. Nicole Simpson and the man found with her had multiple wounds.
What was your life like before that? I guess you could say it was reasonably normal. You're a reasonably normal, dysfunctional family. I had raised Ron and Kim since they were roughly 4 and 6. I hope that at some reasonable point I'd be able to retire, do my thing, and go forward and watch my kids grow up and get married and have kids of their own and enjoy life.
The bodies of Simpson's ex-wife, Nicole Brown Simpson, and Ronald Goldman were discovered early Monday morning.
It should have worked out that way. But on the night of June
13th, 1994... Mark Jacobs. Little Uzi, what? Mark Jacobs.
Oh, it's my friend, Mark Jacobs.
Welcome to the Waverhood. With Wayfair, finding your style is fun. Yeah.
Harvey, thank you so much for joining us. We haven't really had a chance to really speak because you were busy and we were busy here, but your reaction to this day coming, and which kind of we knew he was ill, but now that it's happened, your reaction.
Well, I've just got a flood of reactions. Attending the funeral of a dear friend, this amazing guy who is an agent, but also has just been a friend for 30 plus years. And I was sitting in the synagogue waiting for service to begin. And Charles, you texted me that O.J. Simpson died. And just the counterpoint of Richard Leibner dying, who is just this remarkably amazing, kind, incredible man. And then O.J. Simpson at the same time. It was really hard to process. But boy, did I have different reactions to the two. And look, I'm uncomfortable talking to you about this because I don't have good feelings about O.J. Simpson. And, you know, you mentioned that he was found not guilty, which is true. In the criminal case, a civil jury found that he did indeed kill Ron Goldman and Nicole Brown Simpson and awarded more than $33 million, finding with by clear and convincing evidence that he acted with malice in doing so. So O.J. Simpson is a killer and has been judged by a jury as such. And I have a bunch of reactions. I mean, the thing that I keep coming back to, and I know you talked about, you know, his movie career and everything else, and I had run into him before the murders, and he was a perfectly charming guy. But my reaction is that when he killed his ex-wife, Nicole, he left her on the doorstep, almost decapitated, for her children to find her the next morning, you know, if it weren't for their dog that led another neighbor to the doorstep, the kids would have gone upstairs and seen their mother, the dead on the porch. And I can't get that image out of my head because I've seen the autopsy pictures. So that is what defines O.J. Simpson to me. I also have this deep feeling, and Charles, I don't know if we've ever really talked about this, but O.J. Simpson really helped me understand the concept of celebrity. Because for so long after the trials, I was just amazed and angered, you know, as my friend Dominic Dunn once covered this trial, that O.J. Simpson became kind of a folk hero to a lot of people in Las Vegas. You know, a steady stream of people would come up to him, wanting to take pictures with him. And I couldn't understand it. It just, I couldn't process it. Now I can. That infamy and fame have blended so in our society that there is no distinction between the two. And O.J. Simpson taught me that lesson.
Yeah, Harvey, what you just said is so true. That because after the criminal trial and after the civil trial, he really wasn't out and about in public as much, right? I mean, we'd see him golfing and stuff like that, but he wasn't out in public. And then when he got out of prison, it's almost like he realized what you just said, that infamy and fame are kind of the same thing, and you're going to be treated the same way, because once he got to Las Vegas, he was not hiding from the spotlight at all.
He was celebrated by people who came to Las Vegas.
Do you think he was celebrated, or were people in a macabre sense sort of wanting to have a moment with OJ so that they could then go and say, oh, I got a photo with OJ, or I talked to OJ? I'm sure there were some people who were celebrating him, but I don't think that was, I think most of them were doing it for the macabre. And this is a man who killed some people. And here I am taking a photo.
You know, it's sort of like, you know, an outlaw in the Wild Wild West who became famous, the Jesse James type or whatever. But I don't think it was, oh my God, this is an odd moment. I think they looked at this guy and said, oh my God, look how famous he is. Everybody knows O.J. Simpson. I'm going to take a picture with him. And I think especially over time, it started to blur. And then eventually it didn't matter to people. And people don't remember Ron Goldman, and they don't remember Nicole Brown Simpson. They remember O.J. Simpson, and they know his fame. And that's why I say infamy and fame have blurred to the point where they're one and the same. I want to say one other thing, that as much as, you know, I have these strong feelings about O.J. Simpson, I also think that there was an injustice done to him in this kidnapping trial for which he served prison time. Because I feel like in that case, the judge was basically trying to do the justice that wasn't done in the murder case, and that sentence made no sense to me. So even though I had strong feelings and know he killed these two people, I felt that that prison sentence for what he had done in Las Vegas in that hotel room was unfair.
But no one was going to feel sympathy for him at that point, because I think most people felt, as you did, that he did kill them. And so, who's going to get, and I know the justice system isn't supposed to work that way, and that's what you're talking about.
Yeah, but as a lawyer, I really felt that an injustice in that case was done, even though I also felt that an injustice was done. But that said, a jury clearly ruled he killed these two people. So, and I have no doubt about it. Again, I covered every minute of that trial. And not just the trial, I covered it from the day it happened. And I have, you know, I have doubts about lots of things where I'm not certain anymore about much. I'm certain about that.
Two things, Ron, before we let you go, Ron Goldman, his father, Fred Goldman, his reaction, he told people, was that he wasn't thinking about O.J. Simpson today, that he was focusing on his son, focusing on Ron, and realizing just how long it has been since they lost Ron at O.J.'s hands.
I got to tell you something. I was thinking about Ron today, too. When I was sitting in the funeral service, I was thinking Ron would be in his mid-50s now. And I just thought, wow, that guy whose life was taken when he was so young and vibrant would be, you know, getting up there in age. And he was robbed of that. So that's interesting. I was thinking of Ron myself.
Yeah. And interesting that, you know, and believe me, Fred Goldman, and that you said the $33 million, O.J. didn't pay the lion's share of that, right? I mean, that money is still owed to the Goldman family. And
it was protected. The money was protected the way it was structured. You know, part of it was his NFL pension, and part of it was the way his pension, you know, with his financial advisors was constructed. But, yeah, he really paid virtually nothing in this case. But again, you know, for Fred Goldman, and the fact that O.J. Simpson attacked Fred Goldman, called him money grubbing, and all sorts of other things.
Thank you. I was listening to the news, and they said it's going to get cold. Can you make sure that it looks okay?
Oh. You've been messing with it, right?
Well, I was trying to turn it on. Make sure it's
right. Right. I see those greasy fingerprints all over this thing.
I was trying.
Damn butter bomb.
I was trying, and it worked. I pressed all the buttons, that's what happened.
This thing is greasy as hell.
But it's good to keep it lubricated.
I'll put it at 71.
No, man, you don't want it too hot.
71's fine.
Still got plenty of bananas. Did you finish yours yet?
I've been eating at least 3 to 4 days.
Well, hey, check it out. When they get like this, peel them, put them in a plastic bag, and put them in the freezer.
I have a bunch in the freezer.
Yeah. And don't they taste fantastic when you make a shake? From TMZ, he says that he's pretty sure that he was the one that killed Goldman.
Yeah. Well, they said the only reason
the glove didn't fit is because the doctor had told him to stop taking it. Yeah. So that he swelled up. Mm-hmm. And so he tried to pick it up. Well, I'm just saying they never caught the person that really killed these people. Mm-hmm. So they eventually
never came to light.
So the judge, when the police were caught because he had a messy room in the Las Vegas, they arrested him and gave him 9 years for that. He had nothing to do with the Goldman crime. He got 9 years for a room in the hotel in Las Vegas. So that was a miss, and nobody said anything, nobody came to his defense, they just stepped on him. So that was a mistrial, and that was not right. And TMZ acknowledged that. They said that they were wrong. 9 years. Oh, we're talking about the particle. 2024-25 is coming up. And the nuclear fusion should be complete.
Oh, you're talking about the...
Yeah.
The experiment?
Yeah. They're going to turn it on again.
They turned it on.
I didn't care about that.
Yeah. I didn't check this. What do I get? I was...
sometimes the helicopters weren't as close as they can get to the sun. So they can really capture it. But it just shows the respect that they have. What is that?
That is a reflection of the sun that was actually showing light. So the lens caught the eclipse. You see that?
Uh-huh.
The nail?
Yeah.
That's what was actually showing. But from our perspective, without the glasses, you saw that.
Yeah.
But with the glasses, only this was showing light. So my camera was doing a lot of weird things during the eclipse because it's hard to capture something so bright, mm-hmm. yet not fully showing light because it was 94% covered there, the sun. Mm-hmm. And yet you still see it like the sun. So there's a lot of mysterious things going on.
Well, I went that particular day, I went to Aldi's and I did the shopping and I noticed the darkness.
I even caught a bird in the eclipse. So I think he was confused. He was like, what the hell?
Yeah, exactly. There you go. That's a good observation.
He did not know what to do.
His head, look at his head. He was looking up. Because they know when danger is up. Do you go camping? What feature is that you just did that right now? The 360, right?
Yeah, I was just. There's a lot of people at the planetarium.
Oh, yeah.
Everyone was lined up with their glasses.
Oh, you're looking through the lens. Good.
Yes, sir.
That's the only way you can really see it.
Yeah, but the zooming in is very hard to do.
Yeah.
Because it's so opaque. The lens.
Yeah. But the planetarium has a special type of lens.
Yeah, they had some things, but there were just so many people. But yeah, it was cool. Oh, and then I realized they have a bruise that looks like the eclipse.
How did you get that bruise?
I don't know.
Oh, okay, alright.
Must have hit something. Oh, and me, I bought a couple of beers to drink over there.
Yeah.
And then I get home, I'm like, I didn't really feel nothing.
Ah, oh, shit. Hold on, I'm gonna give you something.
So I was like, what the fuck? No wonder I didn't feel nothing. Because I drank three of them. Usually I just need two just to chill.
Yeah.
But I drank three of them and I'm like, it's more.
I wanted to give you this because.
No, you need that.
No, but check it out. See this right here? See this right here, how it opens? Right here?
Yeah.
You could put a belt on both sides to hold on to the weight.
No, I go to the gym now.
Oh, okay. I'm just saying.
I already, I made my own weights already, too.
You made your own? Yeah.
Yeah, the weights I got work out just fine. I put the extra bar down.
Yeah.
And
what do you think about this weight?
It's heavy for what it is.
Yeah.
You can easily train this into a gun.
We'll see. Well, thanks for checking on the heat.
No, yeah, let me know if you need anything on downstairs.
Yeah, it worked out perfect. You want some more chocolate?
No. I have work from home tomorrow, too.
All right, good.